Hey guys, Ivan here, and in this video we have a couple of very interesting bodybuilding updates, so we are starting with this one. As you can see, it's good Vito with his most recent physique update at 8 weeks out of his first NPC show. And I was looking at this guy, I was admiring this physique, and I was thinking, there is so much talk lately about these new up-and-comers like Michael Crijo, like Andrew Jacked. Although those guys are absolutely amazing, no doubt about that, I'm thinking this guy right here has probably the biggest potential. And not just out of that bunch, you know, the new guys who are switching federations or are just starting bodybuilding. No, I'm actually talking about all bodybuilders in the world, because do you guys know how old Good Vito is? How old this freaking freak right here actually is? Let me tell you, he's 25. That's right, he's only 25. This guy is a kid. He's just a kid. He's 25 years old. Yeah, that's right, let that sink in. He's 25. Can you believe it, guys? Can you believe that this monster right here, with his crazy looking arms, crazy looking lats, crazy big chest, insane legs, and on top of that all, super small, tiny waist, insane V-taper, actually X-taper. This guy is so phenomenal, and he's just a kid, he's only 25 years old. There is so much potential in this one physique. This guy can be the future Mr. Olympia quite easily. I know that has been said about so many bodybuilders who haven't really fulfilled their potential, so it's probably not super smart to make that statement, but look at this guy, he basically has no flaws. Even from behind, you're looking at all these photos and you're thinking maybe he doesn't have a back, maybe he just looks good from the front, from the sides, but actually this guy has great potential to have a really good back. Like, his legs from behind look insane, his insertions in his back are just fine, and obviously this is an older video, he looks so much better right now prepping for the NPC show, and just imagine how good will he be in the next 5 to 10 years if he keeps pushing it. Look at the back, it's not bad, not at all. If you pay close attention to his physique, you will notice that he pretty much has no flaws, no glaring weaknesses. Structure-wise, symmetry-wise, no flaws, not that I can see. Even development, he pretty much doesn't lack any specific muscle group. Everything will grow, get bigger and harder and gnarlier over time for sure. Conditioning is something that he could have been better at, but that's something you fix in one prep. That's not a body part that he needs to like spend a couple of years on improving. No, no, he just needs to come in peeled and just, you know, grow overall, and sky is the limit for this guy. And in this most recent physique update, he looks so much better than ever before. He looks ridiculous. And I'm saying, this guy probably has the most potential in the world right now. You also have, for example, Martin Fitzwater, who's also very young. Nick Walker is also very young. And there are probably a lot of other guys who are young, who have a lot of potential, but I don't think anybody, not one of them, has as much potential as Good Vito. If you guys disagree with me, or you agree, or whatever is on your mind, you can tell me down below in the comment section. If you guys are looking for a really high quality creatine, I will suggest to you Old School Labs Classic Creatine. It is really well micronized and it comes in this awesome looking package. And I know, guys, creatine prices really went up super high, but it's still really important to have those 5 grams up to 10 grams of creatine in every day. Just because the prices went up a little doesn't mean you should stop using creatine. Just buy it, it's not really that expensive. So if you guys also want to support my channel, buying supplements and using the code EVAN really helps me a lot. So if you guys want to show that kind of support, you can do that, the link is down below. Thank you guys. Since we are talking about potential, here is a potential 212 Mr. Olympia champion, that's right. Now, just like with all these guys who haven't really proven themselves, we still have to wait to see them on the stage compared to the best in the world. But right here in this photo, you can see a whole bunch of tremendous potential in this one incredible physique of Dean White. This guy has a crazy backstory. He actually turned pro, and it was basically the same show that he had amateurs and professionals the day after. So he turned pro one day, the next day, he did a pro debut. He even won his pro debut the day after he turned pro. And I think that's pretty insane, pretty ridiculous. And now he's prepping for Arnold Classic UK. Now, these photos are not from today. They are from about a week and a half ago. They are at 4.5 weeks out. And as you can see, he looks absolutely ridiculous. Like, the muscle bellies of this guy are just insane. The fullness in those arms, the width and fullness in that chest, also the legs, the small, tiny waist, huge forearms, small wrists. I mean, this physique looks so ridiculous. And yeah, this was 4.5 weeks out of Arnold Classic UK, so his conditioning was also very good for that point in time. Here is him right now at 3 weeks out. And as you can see, his conditioning is changing rapidly and he's still staying, you know, full and round, but the separation is just coming. Like, look at the chest, how separated it is. Then look at the legs too, they're getting carved up as well. I would say that his legs are a little bit behind as far as mass. I think his upper body is a little bit bigger than his legs, but also this photo was taken from an angle, from a non-legs flattering angle. It was taken from above, so he looks very much upper body dominant, but I don't think his legs are much weaker. They might be lagging a little bit behind, but they are good. And like, looking at this guy, how big he is, it's just crazy to believe that he's only 212 pounds. That's like 96 kilos. For you guys using the metric system, so you can get a better idea, 96 kilos or 212 pounds, that's light. And this guy looks like a monster. So he's probably very short. However, he's doing the 212, and I think he's going to win the Arnold Classic UK. After that, he's going to the Mr. Olympia. How well will he do at the Mr. Olympia? It really depends on who shows up, or actually who doesn't show up. So far, we have no idea who is doing it and who isn't. We are not sure if Derek Lunsford is doing it. We don't know if Sean Clarida is gonna do it. We don't know about Angel Calderon, who is also qualified for the Open. We do know that Kamal Elgargni is gonna be doing 212. So let's say all these guys are doing 212. Sean Clarida, Derek Lunsford, and Kamal Elgargni. I think it would be very difficult for this guy to beat Derek and Sean, because these guys, they look like open bodybuilders, just shorter. They're very round, they're very big, but Kamal Elgargni is much flatter. He's crazy conditioned, but he doesn't have that bubbly round shape, so this guy could beat Kamal, or he could be fourth. That's where I can see him at a Mr. Olympia. We'll see. Again, this guy is new. He never stood against those guys at a Mr. Olympia level, but I think all these photos are just good enough. I think you can get an idea that this guy has a lot of potential, and I think he's like top 3, top 4 in the world in 212 right now. Alright, finally, this weekend we have another show. There have been a couple of quiet weeks with no bodybuilding shows, but we are back. The next show, this weekend, is gonna be Yamamoto Pro Show in Italy. There are other Yamamoto Pro shows, I think there is one in France, so I'll call this one Italy Pro. So as you can see, here is the official list, and it's actually gonna be a pretty good show. As you can see, we have Jamie Johal, Mohamed Elamam, Roman Fritz, Andrea Muzi, Vlad Sukoruchko. All of these guys are pretty well-known names, and they are great bodybuilders. And I redlined another name, because this guy is from Balkans, from around here, from Croatia, as you can see. And he has a lot of potential. I think he's gonna crack the top 5. I think he's going to beat Roman Fritz, who I would have in 6th. As you can see, this guy has a lot of thickness, especially from the back. By the way, his name is Adnan Gosto, though we call him Adoni. And again, he has a lot of muscle, a lot of thickness. He turned pro last year, and now he's gonna do his pro open debut. And I think he's going to beat this German guy right here, Roman Fritz. And if you guys follow my channel, you know I'm a huge fan of Roman. I really wanted to see him do well. Before Tampa and Texas, I had him potentially cracking the top 6. I really wanted to see him do well. However, he disappointed. He was 11th and 13th. And looking at these photos, even though he's talking about trying to bring something bigger and fuller to this Yamamoto Pro Show, I don't think he's gonna do it. I think he looks pretty much the same as always. I will still be a huge fan of Roman. I know how passionate he is about bodybuilding, how hard he's working, and I like his personality and all that, but, you know, at some point you need to realize, this guy is not really a great bodybuilder. I still do like his physique, I respect the conditioning that he's bringing, but apparently judges are looking for something else. And that something else is more muscle, more mass, that Roman simply doesn't have. After seeing this video, I think maybe he's gonna be a little bit fuller, but full enough to be top 5, no. Here is what Jamie Johal looks like right now, the giant. This guy is like 6'9" or something, he's really, really tall. And because of that, I would love to see him do well, because it's not something that happens usually. Usually, bodybuilding is dominated by short guys, and this guy is a freaking giant, so I would love to see him do well, but he's still, I mean, it's gonna be probably mission impossible for him to completely fill up that frame. Now, this V-taper, this X-taper looks amazing, it looks very aesthetic, but when he stands next to the other guys, he's going to be an odd man out, that's for sure. The other guys are gonna be much fuller and rounder, but I do have this guy actually in top 3, beating a lot of bodybuilders who are obviously much shorter, probably like more filled out. He also has a lot of great traits, so top 3 would be a great result for him. Top 2, cracking the top 2 at this show, it's going to be really tough for all of these guys, because you have this freaking monster in that mix, Vlad Suhoruchko. This guy is an absolute freak, he's a really big guy, a mass monster. However, the last time we saw him on stage, I think it was Tampa Pro, he didn't look very good. Like, his conditioning could have been better, and also both his lats and shoulders looked like they had Sintel in them. I don't know if it was Sintel or he was simply injecting his gear in those areas, but there were bumps, it didn't look normal, it looked really, really off, and I think that's why the judges placed him a little bit lower than he probably would have placed if that wasn't an issue. So hopefully he will fix that, hopefully he stopped injecting those spots. But as far as like muscularity, conditioning, shape, everything really, this guy is in my top 2 in second spot. Why wouldn't he win? Well, because we have Andrea Muzzi doing this show as well. I know, it's like his 20th show this year. He placed so many times in like top 2, top 3. I think he was second a couple of times, and he just can't seem to win. And all of these shows, most of them at least, he was in really good shape, but the last show he wasn't in shape. The last show he was off because it was I don't know which show in a row. And now he took some time off, he took a break, and I think he refreshed his body quite enough. And it looks like he brought a new level of conditioning. He looks peeled right now. He looks dry, dry, dry. And I think that's going to be a winner of this show quite easily. I think the difference between him and whoever ends up in second is going to be rather large. I think this guy deserves to win this show. He still didn't give up. He put his health in big risk doing this many shows this year, peaking so many times. I'm sure his body is destroyed completely this year. Hopefully he will recover. Hopefully he will survive the Mr. Olympia. After that, I think he should take like a year off of everything, because he really tortured his body. And I think he deserves that victory. I think he deserves to go to the Mr. Olympia. I don't know if anybody else tried this hard and was so close to getting that Mr. Olympia qualification. So I think this show it's his to lose as well. And I think he's not going to lose it. I think he's going to win it, because as you can see, he looks shredded, dry as hell. Anyways, guys, that's gonna do it for this video. If you enjoyed watching this video, please like it. And if you want to see more videos like this, just click that subscribe button. It also means a lot. So thank you guys so much for watching. All the best, guys, and bye-bye.